Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is
He said, Tom, go ahead and start the intro.
All right. You think you can do better?
Yes.
All right. Hello, folks!
Did you like that?
All right,
see, you had no enthusiasm when
Welcome
you did the intro.
To the Great Outdoors. This is the Vengeance 295 A18. So Vengeance is our toy hauler line.
They are.
And
yes,
this,
yes.
If you need a big garage, this has 18 feet.
18 feet.
Well, not a garage, I guess it's all one area.
Well, it's a living room space, all inclusive type
Most
of an area.
Most efficient use of your
It is,
area.
And the reason that the 295 A18 is a popular model for us is because, man, these toys that they're coming out with now, I had a gentleman come in that had a 14 foot razor.
Yeah.
And it's not gonna fit in a 12 foot garage. It's
no.
just not. He's gonna need something like this, and having that 18 foot garage from the countertop all the way to the back, 18 feet, so you can put all kinds of bikes in there, four wheelers, whichever you can think of. So that's why this one's super popular.
Let us show you some stuff on the outside and then we'll head on to the inside.
Yeah, let's do it.
So we're starting on the rear of the camper. We wanted to show you how this folds down. So you have these cables right here, and you just undo these if you want to use this as a ramp to go up into the coach with your toys. But it's nice that they've started doing this because this makes as a back deck.
Now what you'll notice on this deck is that this is a simple system actually. You have these little metal feet that'll clasp right into the housing area here. It just locks into place, just like so. And you can set this up and gosh, like 15 seconds or something like that. And then this has got a door on here that you can utilize as well. And just kind of locks into place. So, mate, you could put a grill out here.
Oh yeah, I've seen even accessories where you can put like a little trash can here, a grill over there. A
couple reclining chairs, a fishing pole.
That I want to use one of these days, drive right up to the lake, and so that like this part's like hanging off the water.
Yeah,
that
a lot of
so
people do that.
Fun.
Yeah, you got casting platform and everything back here.
You also notice that this has a spot for a backup camera if you decide to go that route. You also have a light up here. You also have this tent wall, so what you can do is roll these up and buckle these in place. That way you can have like a mesh that you can see through. Yeah, you can easily go in and out to keep the bugs out if you want to be able to get that outdoor feeling.
Yep.
Easy access to your deck without letting other things in that you don't want to have in the camper.
Yeah, let's walk around and show some features on the other side before we go on the inside. What do you think?
All right.
All right, Mater. I'm going to go ahead and kick out this awning.
Perfect.
We can show the people.
Yeah, you'll notice that it has the lights that light up underneath for the LEDs. You also have the outside speakers. You also have a spot to put a TV. 110 hookup right here. And then this is a spot to hook into a TV antenna if I could get this thing open. There we go. So yeah, you have everything to hang out here. That's a vent, so you can open this vent, and then there's one kind of catty corner to this to be able to air out your garage.
Yeah, now this awning made is a Solera awning.
Uh-huh.
So this one's got the adjustable elbows on it. Now we do have a camper right next to us, but what's good about this is got the adjustable elbows where you can kind of pitch it and slope it.
Mm-hmm.
So if it starts to rain or something like that and you need to shoo the rain off in either direction, or you can use it as a sun blocker, dropping it down for those nice little sunsets that you have, that, you know, if you need to block your sun a little bit, you can do that too. So that's a great option to have on a coach like this.
Large grab assist handle. It also has the screen door on the inside. And if you have little people with you, you can block them from rolling down the stairs. And then
you'll get some pass-through storage here on this coach as well. Ideal for lawn chairs, anything else that you can think of, fishing poles. And then you're gonna have two 30 LP bottles on this coach. You'll have one here and then one on the opposite side of the coach. It just mirrors this one right here.
You also have a solar ready port right here. Now this says powered by ZAMP, but you can really put any solar panel on there as long as you have the right connector.
Yeah, and I'm a fan of this, mate, only for the fact that you're not putting them on the roof. You know, the more accessories that you put on the roof, you know, the more, you know, could be susceptible to rain, but that's not the biggest issue. The biggest thing with these is that when you put them on the roof, everybody likes to park under shade trees.
Sure.
You know, here you can bring it out on the cable, move it around as you need to, and get that maximum use of the efficiency of the system throughout the course of the day.
Solar panels are great for recharging your batteries. Yeah. Now that doesn't mean that you'll be able to run your air conditioner off that or your microwave or anything that's 110 powered, but
that's what the generator's for, mate.
That is why you have.
And you have a generator on here.
Yeah, you have a 4,000 watt EVAP Cummins Onan generator. Now the cool thing about this generator is it's the EVAP. That means what happens is if you have gasoline in here, it will drain out of the carburetor so that you don't ruin your carburetor
if it sits.
Yeah, if it just sits for too long.
And folks, these are actually designed to run. So we get a lot of customers that'll come in and say, well, I don't want to run my generator or whatever. You know, they're truly designed to run, and you don't want the seals to dry up on you. So go ahead and run it as much as you want.
Yeah. The other cool thing about the setup with toy haulers in general, but this including this system, is it has a built-in fuel station that not only can feed the generator, but also feeds all your toys. So if you needed to fill up your four-wheeler or whatnot, you can do that. And it's all—
What's a whatnot?
A whatnot?
What's,
that's the new
whatnot?
Technical type of UTV that you haven't seen yet.
Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, fiberglass front, guys. You'll notice it has the LED lights, so it looks super sharp going down the road. It even has some up lights, which makes it look even fancier.
Yeah, and mate, one of the biggest questions that we get is, hey, what kind of tow vehicle do you need for this guy?
Ah, yes.
And there's two sets of weights. First one's gonna be the dry weight. And the dry weight is basically calculated or weighed as the coach comes off the assembly line.
With
so just
options,
as it sits, with all the furniture and everything on board. And then you have your GVWR weight, which is after you load up all of your toys, your water, your gear, whatever, the GVWR is the fully loaded weight. So two types of weight. So dry coming off the line, you're at 9,134. And then the GVWR with all of your stuff loaded, you're at 12,996. So roughly 13,000 pounds. So you could put about 4,000 pounds worth of cargo in here. And at that weight, at 13,000 pounds, you're definitely looking at a 3/4 ton truck at the very least.
One ton is okay too, obviously.
One ton, yeah, but at least a 3/4 ton.
Yeah, diesel, you're gonna get all your power out of the diesels usually.
Yeah.
You might be rated for it on a gas motor, but man, it'd be rough.
Yeah. So as I mentioned before, this is your second 30 LP bottle right here.
Yep.
And then here's your opposite door on the driver's side for your pass-through storage. Here's your 30 amp cord that you'll get to power the coach. And it comes with a nice little handy dandy sprayer that you'll see on the on your docking station here in a minute. But before we get to that, this is going to be a 6 gallon direct spark ignition water heater, both gas and electric options on both. Your dump valves are gonna be located right underneath that. And as we kind of continue on down, mate.
Yeah, the other thing to note about those dump valves is, one, this is a fully enclosed underbelly. So if you wanted to go a little bit later in the season, you can do that.
Yeah.
It does have 12 volt heat pads on the tanks themselves as well. Now you can eventually freeze anything, right? Including this coach, but you're hopefully one of the last guys to freeze instead of one of the first.
Well, it just helps prevent it, right?
Right.
I mean, you know, no coach is gonna be solid 100%. Yeah. You know, we get a lot of customers saying, well, I want a 4-season coach that'll never freeze. Folks, there's nothing out there that
don't
exists.
Don't believe
like
them
that.
If they tell you that it's a
you
four-season.
You need to run very
there's
far
no such
away.
Thing as a four-season coach.
There isn't, okay? The way that we present it here is it's a three-season extended coach type thing. We'll give you ideas as far as how you can help that along. Even the best-built coaches are not designed for 4 seasons.
Right.
So, you know, kind of do your homework and research. Let us educate you a little bit on that. So we're here to the docking station. And mate, did you take a shower this morning?
I did. Did so you? I don't need another.
Are you sure?
I appreciate it though.
Okay. Well, this thing,
I know you're looking for my best interest.
I am. Yeah, I'm, you know, I'm just trying to keep you. I'm just trying to keep the sex appeal there, man.
Right. Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, well, you never know, right? So this little guy is awesome because it's got hot and cold water features on here. So you can spray your pet off with it. Maybe you go to a camping site and it's got a, you know,
every time
a yucky
you say
table.
That, I always imagine like this high pressure, like little tiny dog just like rolling
like
as
my
you,
dog, like Gabe.
Fire hose this poor thing.
Yeah, my yeah. Gabe, my 11
yeah,
pounder.
Yeah.
Yeah. He would not like this.
No.
But you know, if you have like a big
but your toys,
German Shepherd
like that,
toys,
yeah.
You know, you just get done, you can spray them off the picnic table, you can do all that. So whatever you can think of with this little guy. You have your satellite and cable hookups right here. You have a black tank flush that's located right here too. Now your black tank flush is going to help you clean your black tank. It's a system that's already built in. That eliminates having to come in with a separate hose into your coach with a little T-handle on it and sticking it down in there and cleaning it out. And then you have a quick knob right here, which is a tank fill and your city connection. So it's not, it's one fill hole, but you got a bypass valve that will let you go to your tank fill or your city water connections.
Over here, you have your fuel station. So the way this works is you have your fuel pump right here. This is where you push a button and it has a 5-minute timer on it. And basically what it'll do is it will turn on your fuel pump so that you can pump gas into your whatnot.
That's a
yes.
Whatnot.
Yeah.
I'm gonna totally start using that. Yeah. You know, whatever your whatnot is that you can go ahead and fill
I'll
that
go ahead
up.
And show you guys what this looks like.
Oh, you don't have a key for that either.
I don't. If I could.
How come our cameraman is the only one that's got a key to this thing and we don't?
So this is what that looks like. Just a normal gas.
Yeah, it's a fuel station.
Yeah.
And 30 gallons on this one, folks.
Yeah. Let's show them some stuff on the inside.
Let's do it. All right. Let's check out some features in here.
So this is the inside, everyone. As you can see, it's very long.
It's very long. Mate, this is a party coach. Have you ever seen one of those long buses?
Well, this would be
awesome. Where you get all your buddies and they're drinking, you have a little bus driver up front.
That's one of the best things about this is it has room for everybody to seat.
How many people can you sit in here, you think?
Well,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, maybe just right here.
This could be like the hangout area. Like if everybody brings their coach, this is the one that you hang out in because it actually fits everyone.
Yeah.
The other thing that you'll notice is it has blackout shades on all the windows right here. So if you did want to put your toys in here and hide them, you can do that. This is also an emergency exit. That one is right behind Tom too.
Oh.
And that's how you open that. The other way that this thing works is, let me lock this into place real quick, is this is a happy jack system. So what this does is this raises and lowers. Tom, could you go push the button for the bottom half of this? So there's four pins, guys. Right here is one of them. So you pull those pins and then this drops down, but you don't do that until this is raised up all the way.
Are you ready for me, mate?
You can raise
it
up.
Are you gonna configure that into the sleeping area or are you just gonna move it up?
Well, you can go ahead and raise it up.
Okay.
This is your drink holders and then this rolls into a bed and then this does the same. And so it touches, goes all the way across. And then this one does the same thing. This one's a happy jack style.
Yeah, mate, those just fold up against the wall because that's another question. Yeah. How do I get all my toys to fit in here?
Right. So this
very,
is how that
simple.
One works. And there's a hook somewhere around here. But yeah, that folds up to the side. And then the cool thing about these is a lot of people have these super tall roll cages and everything.
Yeah.
And everybody's worried about, oh, will it fit underneath?
Right.
These are specifically made just for that. So as you can see, there's four little pins right here, or two on this, for this side anyway. You pull these pins, and then you can stop there, Tom, that's fine, that's enough. You have a little note right here, it says, release to roll sofa back to vertical, and then lock when you need to go the other way. So we're gonna release, so I pull it that way, and then that folds down. So this one does the same thing, and then you can drive your toys in here, not have to worry about hitting that roll cage.
Yeah, exactly. And that's exactly why these that's why exactly why Vengeance came out with the setup like this. So
you also have some power ports over here, so USB power ports, right, and over here you
charge also, your cell phones,
yeah, or whatever, so you can do that just off the battery. You don't have to turn on the generator to be able to charge stuff.
Yeah, you want to make this into our bunk bed configuration, mate?
Oh sure, why not. So we would need to raise this up a little bit higher, so while you're doing that, I'll go ahead and raise. So I went ahead and pulled these four pins out.
Yep, and we're gonna go ahead and lower this into the bunk configuration, mate, if you wanna help me out with that.
And then we also, just so you guys know, these little are stabilizers or whatever for extra weight support. We pulled those down.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead and push this button to drop it down the rest of the way. You can sleep a lot of people in here, too.
You can sleep a lot of people in here. So considering the party coach on here, so this is actually a double bunk bed configuration. And what's also nice too, while this is coming down, is you're gonna get this removable carpet too that you can lay down on your main floor. Once you kick out all your toys, you'll be able to open this up and spread it out on the whole floor and give you that room, living room feel. So this bed is going to automatically stop at this location. You have a stopper ring in here. So it's not gonna go down any farther than this. And then once this one comes down, the leg, it'll just stop once it hits the legs. And there you go. And now your bunk bed configuration is set up. The way you bring this up is you just reverse the process. You bring this all the way up. Now you can kind of bypass this whole thing. If you wanted to get four big guys to lift this all the way up to the ceiling and pin it in, you can definitely do that.
But that's the hard way.
That's the hard way of doing it. But to bring this back up, you got to lift the entire system up, bring this up, lock it into place, and then bring the couch system back down.
You also notice that this unit is double ducted, so you'll have air on this side as well as over on this side, so it kind of shifts around. You also have all LED lights throughout the entire coach, so it's going to keep the unit cooler and not running as hot. It's also not going to burn as much battery juice to.
One of the things you'll notice too is you'll have the tie downs down here, and these are 2,500 pound tie downs, and they go directly into the frame. Now you can, now all the way, when we talk about 18 feet, so the very end of this counter all the way to the back is 18 feet. So you can definitely put a couple quads up here, razor bikes, whatever you guys can manage to cram into this garage, you can definitely do it.
And then this is a table that fits right in between the two couches. And you can take this outside too if you wanted to. So it's nice to have a picnic table that's portable that you can put wherever you want to.
Speaking of seating areas, mate, this one also comes with a nice little swivel rocker.
Well, and you would have one of the nicest camping chairs out by the fire if you happen to bring that out there underneath your awning or whatever.
Not too close to the fire. You don't want to burn the fabric.
You also have a pull-down sink faucet, the high rise, so that you can get big pots and pans in here. You'll notice this is just one big basin, so it's a lot easier to work with instead of the tiny split one. Glass stove top on here. This also doubles as a backsplash if you need to. And this has a convection microwave. This is called a halftime oven or convection microwave. So you can pop your popcorn in here, you can cook pizza in here, you can cook your chicken, bake bread, everything from this. This runs off of 110 power, so you have to turn your generator on to work this. So you don't have to use any gas for this portion. But it's nice to have all those features in one thing, and that gives you an entire huge cabinet area, which toy haulers are notorious for not having enough cabinetry.
Right.
So the fact that they can utilize that for an all-in-one purpose thing to give you more cabinetry is great.
Yeah, and sometimes people are a little intimidated by the convectional oven because they don't know how to work it. Folks, give yourselves a couple times to learn it, and it'll...
People love it.
Once you use it,
you'll never go back.
You can cook a turkey in there or a chicken, and you can also heat up a cup of coffee, so...
8 cubic foot refrigerator. This is a gas electric one, not just a... Some guys are moving towards the electric one only, which is bigger than this, but that means if you are off the grid, then you're toast, unless you want to run your generator 24/7 to keep your food cold, which, how annoying is that?
I don't know if I like that idea that they're just going with electric. I think that kind of defeats the purpose of being a multi-purpose unit.
Yeah, so this is a great option, I feel like.
Yep.
You also have some high storage if you needed to be able to put something that you don't need to get to very often right there.
Like all your junk food?
Junk food, sure.
You eat a lot of junk food.
I love junk food.
Do you?
Yeah.
Okay.
This TV is on a swing arm, so if you want to be able to Swing it out. You can do
and
that.
And it swings out far.
Yeah.
I mean, you can, man, you can crank this thing all over the place.
Yeah. Bluetooth built into the stereo up here. More storage up here, of course. And then all your controls for all the lights are over on this side.
Right here. So all your in lights. And one of the cool things about this that we need to point out too is these blue neon lights. Now, Mate knew that we were doing this video today, and he wore his blue shirt.
That's right. So he's trying to
match. He might blend into the background. So if you lose him behind the neon light, that's why. But all your lights right here. Your bed control lift is right here. Your awning extender is located right here as well. And then before we go upstairs, a couple things that we want to point out is this is where your converter is at. This is where all your breakers and your fuses are located. And then also down here, right here, is your LP detector. Now, this is an important feature to have on your coach, but you also have to understand a couple things. This little guy will run 24/7. There is no way of turning this off unless you absolutely disconnect your battery or you have a battery disconnect, which this coach has. Now, this is very sensitive to aerosol sprays, deodorants, and stuff like that, so you want to be careful when you're using those items around here. And chances are, if it goes off and you're using like Pam cooking spray or, you know, right guard deodorant or whatever.
I'm an all natural type of guy.
I know, I can
only lemons.
But if you're ever using one of those items and this guy goes off, chances are it's probably what it is. You'll want to open up the windows and get some breeze over here to clear that out. But just kind of be cognizant of that, because people don't understand sometimes how that feature works. They'll say, Tom, I just bought the thing, I got a brand new battery, and my coach is dead. Well, that's because your LP sensor was working. You don't have a battery disconnect and you didn't disconnect your battery. So
over here we have some outside speaker controls. You also have a digital thermostat and your on-off switch for your generator. So the way that you do these, just so you know, is you push the bottom button to prime it and then you push the start button. Yeah, come on up, guys. I'll show you the rest of the coach. Tom is already sitting in the shower, enthusiastic about showing off the bathroom.
I am. You know, mate, you're always putting me in the shower.
Well, I dare say you put yourself in the shower.
Oh, you dare to say that?
I dare say.
Well, you know, I'm a bigger guy than you are. I'm taller. It gives you more of a preference as far as how big this shower actually is.
Are you going to bring up the fact of who won the triathlon still for the foot race portion?
No, absolutely not.
No?
You don't want to bring it up? And I can give you excuses as far as why I didn't beat you. But, you know, everybody's got excuses, right? So it's just a matter of whether...
Hey.
It was a legitimate excuse. I didn't train at all, mate.
I didn't train at all.
I didn't train, and you beat, and you trained, and you only beat me by 5 seconds. My ankle was bothering me. Hey, when you get older, when you get my age, mate, you'll understand. But you're not there yet. You're a young whippersnapper still. So check out the shower in here, guys. So I got a nice little skylight so you can work on your suntan while you're taking a shower. And you actually have quite a bit of room in here. You have this nice little partition glass here that will open up. And this gives you a lot more room. They did away with the shower curtains, which, you know, I hate that because they stick to you and all that when you're trying to take a shower. So you got a lot of space in here. And then, man, you get a couple big medicine cabinets in here. In fact, you get two. You get one here, and then you get one here on this side. Get some cabinet space underneath here as well. Nice sink here, foot flush toilet there. So really nice spacious bathroom in here.
And this is the Jack and Jill is what they call this, when the bathroom can go into the hallway or into the bedroom. So if you want easy access, you know, I like how big that bathroom is. It feels like you could actually use that as a changing room if you wanted to, as opposed to the, you know, where they cramp you into like a tiny spot.
Probably could.
Yep. You'll notice you have tons of room to be able to walk around this bed. Another emergency exit. These are the pleated shades. So these are like a fabric type material.
Oh,
beautiful. Well done.
Well,
8.5.
Yeah, because when you take a shower and you're all relaxed, you want to see how quickly you can get back into bed, right?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Well, yeah, it's comfortable, man. This is a nice mattress, mate.
Large closet area on both sides. You also have storage that's very deep, actually, on the top part. And then you also have USB outlets on both sides, as well as 110 outlets on both sides. You also have storage underneath here with the struts so that it'll hold itself up if you want to. And then another thing to mention, well, and I can't really show you on this, if you were to look on the floor of this unit, you'd notice that this is 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking, not OSB chipboard, which is very important when you're talking about campers because, you know, the old saying is, how do you make a 1-inch OSB turn into a 1/2-inch OSB?
What's the joke, mate? You get it wet?
You pour some water on it. So if you have a coach that is OSB, it's not a funny joke. It's a serious topic, Tom.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. But anyway,
I thought it was, well, I just didn't want you I didn't want you to make feel bad.
Yeah.
You told a joke and I didn't laugh at it, even though it was
kind of dumb. Okay. You also have a TV backer right here, as well as TV hookups.
Well, thanks for joining myself and mate on the 295A18 Vengeance journey.
Yes.
Hopefully we explained a lot of things to you and kind of gave you a good overview.
Yes.
Just kidding. Yeah, Vengeance is pretty much our only fifth wheel toy hauler line that we carry now. We have many more in stock. If you like this product and you're looking for something, maybe something with a separate garage, we have those too. So
absolutely,
you can reach out to us at 970-313-4337, or if you want to go ahead and shoot me a direct email, you can do that too at tom@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.
You can also check out our website. We have tons of pictures, more videos. If you want to see more videos as we do them, you can hit the subscribe button. That'll alert you to that.
Yep, we take in trades. We have a full service and parts store here.
We do financing.
We're full, we're one-stop shop.
We are a one-stop shop.
One-stop shop.